Atlanta University Art Galleries, and I'm glad that you could join us this evening for our production by our artist in residence, Gabrielle Fulton. Born in Athens, Georgia, and raised in Atlanta, Ms. Fulton is an award-winning filmmaker and playwright who received her BA from Columbia University, an MFA in writing for the screen and stage from Northwestern University. Her award-winning short film, Irreconcilable, received official selection status at both the American Black Film Festival in New York City and the Atlanta Film Festival. Starring Jasmine Guy, Crystal Fox, and Dick Gregory, the film previously aired on HBO and was showcased in the Atlanta Film Society's New Maverick Showcase. As a filmmaker, Ms. Fulton directed the documentary short, If We So Choose, about the 1964 public accommodations protest to integrate the Varsity Restaurant in her hometown of Athens. Her other non-scripted work included The Center, a television pilot for an international singing competition, and Hip Hop Diaspora, a project optioned by MTV Networks. Last summer, her play Uprising premiered in Atlanta, Georgia at Horizon Theater Company and was later shown in Alexandria, Virginia. Her other productions have been developed and workshopped at institutions such as the Chicago Dramatists, the Alliance Theater, the DC Women's Voices Theater Festival, and the 1 Minute Play Festival. Tonight, she will present the dramatic work entitled Passing Black. It was inspired by the first Atlanta Annual held at Clark Atlanta University in 1942. We hope that you will enjoy. Without further ado, I now present our artist in residence, Gabrielle Fulton.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Poole. You're amazing. I appreciate you giving me this opportunity to be the artist in residence at this fine, fine gallery. I love this place. Dr. Poole invited me here less than a year ago, and I walked in and I was just like, oh, it's just amazing. It's a gym, and I didn't know anything about it, and I grew up not far from here, so I was very upset about that, and I felt like more people needed to know about this place, and so we talked, and Dean Taylor was a huge part of making this happen. Dr. Poole led the way, and I'm so happy to be here with you all today, as well as Professor Obi, who has allowed me to be a teacher in the speech and theater department. So I've really enjoyed working with students, teaching screenwriting, and we are going to have a reading of student works. I want to mention that to you all. Student works, that's going to be the first week in May. There should be more information going out soon about that, but the students have created some incredible short screenplays, so please look forward to hearing more about that. So, Passing Black. Let's see. There are so many things that swirled around my mind just being here at Clark Atlanta University. And one of those is, I feel, you know, first of all, I felt foolish. I didn't know that this fantastic gallery existed, but also I felt that I didn't know that W.E.B. Du Bois taught here for so many years. I didn't realize that. I didn't get it. He wrote The Soul of Black Folk here. What? You know, it was unfortunately news to me. But it's exciting news, and news that I think more people should know about. And theater is a great way to get that kind of news out into the world and into the minds of more and more people. So, what you're about to experience today is not the entire play. In fact, it's only a small kernel of what the play will eventually be. And so I'm going to say it's not a reading. This is a conversation. It's a conversation between you, the work, these fine actors that I'm about to introduce, and me, the playwright. So my process is, you know, everybody has their process, and part of mine is channeling, and I kind of spent time just channeling various thoughts and ideas that I and the research that I've been doing on the art annuals, on Dr. Boyce, on Hale Woodruff, on these United States and how we are a mixed race culture. But we don't think about it like that. We look at things as black or white, but if your family's been here any period of time, we actually are, you know, we will see that we are a mixed race culture. And those are some of the things that are coming out in this work. But it's really compacted right now. And I'm hoping that we'll be able to do another event later this year when the work has blossomed more, right? So it's titled Passing Black, and I wrote this to deal with the intersection of art and politics, and you all know this whole Rachel Dolezal controversy, and it's sort of like what would happen if you had a Rachel Dolezal in 1942, who really wanted to be a part of these first art annuals. I don't want to preface it too much. I think I've already said enough, but I'm very much looking forward to your feedback. That's what this really is about. It's a conversation, and you know, it's kind of fun to be a part of developing work. So. Who knows? You might come back in a couple months and see something you said in the play. So, without further ado, I want to introduce these amazing actors. And I feel sad because I'm like, man, I wish I had more, you know, because they take some more juiciness, you know, to give them. But they've already given me so much just in the short conversation that we've had about this work. So, first. We have Naima Carter-Russell. And then we have Tinashe Kujitsi. Tinashe Kujessa. Kujessa. Thank you. My apologies. Then there's Keith Arthur Bolden.
Simple, square, and low. Great room with a fireplace, a flag kitchen, half a step below, and the lower woodshed beyond. Steep, strong stairs led up to the sleep, while without was a brook, a well, and a mighty elm.
You are nostalgic.
Du Bois moves on to the painting, Farm Boy, for a closer look.
He is not.
He's the look of all the chore boys.
I can feel the sweat dripping down his back.
Shirt sticking to his skin, calloused palms.
Patiently he waits to be a man.
Man chores, but still a boy.
Wishing only to be grown up.
How old is old? In the service, perhaps?
In this war?
If he's lucky.
No, he has big dreams.
A farm of his own?
He's much too wise for that. Look at the forehead. No, can't you see? He's a mathematician.
Waiting to be freed.
Count the stars by day.
For the perspective.
It seems off, no?
Yeah, perhaps. It works, does it not?
Somehow it does.
Masterful.
What I love about the arts, Negro art in particular. A watercolor, yes?
You may have missed your calling.
It seems so.
Aye, this one.
This one. Like a car accident. I can't take my eyes off of it.
It moves. It sways.
It prays.
And we are all lifted by the Spirit.
The Spirit of our resolve.
Our overcoming. Our rising from the grip of death.
We live.
Fully, vibrantly, completely. That's Flemister. He's from here.
I come to stretch my legs and you take me to Sunday morning service.
Don't worry, there won't be an altar call. We will take an offering, though.
For your great work, dedication to the imagery of our people, and contribution to society, I gladly offer a tithe.
Wait till you see this piece. Mm. You may want your money back. Has me quite the conundrum. I could use a bit of advice, warning.
Do not preface me, young man.
Woodruff removes the cloth from a covered canvas.
What is this monstrosity?
I love it.
The vulgarity.
The intrigue. Surely the nudity doesn't bother you.
Of course not.
Then what? Because I
can't show it to anyone.
But it's a...
The truth.
Yes, it's art telling a truth. Two babies suckling.
From the bosom of a Negro woman. One black, one white.
Yet she is regal. Look at her head.
The angle. She is proud.
And the cloth?
From the Ashanti of Ghana, Kente.
This is a bold new artist. American flags emblazoned within each strip of cloth woven into the whole.
Who's the artist?
I've never heard of him. A Georgian. Which is great, but I cannot present this work for exhibition.
Why not? You're more interested in still life than real life?
A still life showcases excellent execution of tone and style. Look at it.
I thought you were the creator of this concern. Substantive things related to the issue of the day.
Like lynching. The Flemister does that.
Yes, but there are others. Why not delve into strict political rather than couching political ideas in sentimental Christian theology?
You're too hard on Christianity.
I won't deny its merits. I do love a good tale. There is more won for us in the political.
Maybe next year. But this year we set the standard. Technical expertise and work of the highest quality is what will set us up for success for years to come.
Enter Philip. Excuse me.
We're close for the day.
Mr. Woodruff, wow, it's you. I'm actually here to speak with you, if you have a moment.
And you are?
That's me then. I'm Philip Acosta.
Ah, I see. It's a compelling work.
Full of intrigue.
I'm very proud of it.
Where are you from, Miss Cossett?
Orkney County.
The Georgia guy.
Born and bred.
What high school did you attend?
I did.
Athens High, not good enough for you?
You mean Athens High and Industrial, sir. Greek, Latin, science, history, literature, and shop. Had I gone to Athens Industrial, well, I wouldn't be the artist I am today.
And your church home?
I fashion myself similar to you, I suppose. No church home for me, sir.
I beg your pardon.
I don't mean to be rude. You're Dr. Dubois, right? I read that religion wasn't...
Miss Carlson, you do know that this is an exhibition of Negro works.
Yes, that's why I'm here.
A regular Walter White.
Are you questioning my racial heritage?
Not at all. Of that, I am quite confident. I am instead wondering, how is it exactly that you lost your whiteness?
I'm sorry. I don't understand.
Sure you do.
But Professor Du Bois, you yourself...
Negro!
...of mixed race heritage. Are you really in a position to question my ethnicity?
Let's not be rude.
Stolen from your family and forced to associate?
What of my Negro ancestry, however distant?
What exactly did it come... When exactly did it come to be your strategy for survival?
So you think I'm just fooling my Negro folks?
All right, that's enough.
I just want to be a part of the conversation.
Miss Carlson lost her whiteness. For now, when do you plan to go back and get it? Once you've lost all of the Negro-only contests?
I don't think I've experienced anything quite as hurtful.
Really? Living in the southern United States, then you most certainly are not Negro. Scene 2, 2015, Clark Atlanta University Art Gallery. Jared, a 19-year-old CAU student, painstakingly packs a large painting under Dr. Calla Tubman's direction. Although 60 years old, Calla looks very young for her age.
Pull it a little closer on the side. Yes, like that. That's it. Perfect.
I was worried about the edges, but...
No, that's fine. Now do the other side.
Enter Trish, mid-40s and styled.
I'm looking for Calla Tubman.
Yes.
The gallery director. Is she here? I wanted to see how the packing of the Carlson painting is coming along.
Oh.
Well, we're just so excited about it, thought I'd just, you know, see how it's going.
I see.
You're quite lucky. The collection here is surprisingly rich.
This is your first time visiting the Clark Atlantic University Galleries.
I haven't heard of it before.
Not until I saw you at Tanner and Smithsonian.
Oh, really?
Is Calla available?
Dr. Tubman is, in fact, available.
Would you mind letting her know I'm here? Tell her it's Trish Lewison.
From the Museum of Modern Art.
I know who you are, Miss Lewison.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You look so young, I mistook you for a student.
How kind.
I'm just so excited to see the Carlson. You'll forgive me, won't you?
She offers handshake, but Calla has already turned toward Jared, who puts finishing touches on the packaged artwork.
The Carlson is here. Our expert packager, Jared, is on the case.
Hello.
Is he a student?
We train students for all museum responsibilities.
I'm sure budget is tight, but you should really consider hiring an expert.
He is an expert.
But he's using bubble wrap and blankets. You need a crate. A custom-built wooden crate fitted to the exact measurements of the work.
Miss Lewison, we are well aware of how to protect our art.
I don't mean to be offensive,
I understand.
I just care so much about the work.
Is that so?
Of course.
Humor me with an answer to one question, then.
Yes, anything.
Out of all the works in this gallery, all the African-American works available to you, why did you choose this artist?
You don't like the Carlson.
Answer the question.
You don't find her work relevant?
If you must know, I do.
Then what's the problem?
I asked you first.
Well, I find her work fascinating. It directly speaks to the issues of her day and today. The Carlson piece is just the event art we've been waiting for.
And yet, when she was alive, you have nothing to do with her.
I'm not sure what you mean. Besides, it's time for her to be mainstream.
Why now? After systematically keeping her and African-American artists like her out of mainstream art work.
Institutions have their own ways of
holding others back.
I have personally fought to increase the amount of African-American works in our collection.
Jacob Lawrence, Romare Bearden.
And now Philippa Carlson.
Still, why her?
She's thoughtful and provocative.
Provocative, yes. Most certainly.
Commerciality keeps the doors open.
And the membership filled.
We are in the same business. I don't understand your...
disdain?
Yes. I find it highly unwarranted.
Did you know that Philippa Carlson was white?
What?
White. Caucasian.
I'm sorry. What?
I didn't mean to burst your bubble.
That's impossible. I mean... why would you even have it in your gallery if she were?
We have the works of several white artists. They were gifted to us.
No, I've done all the research.
Apparently not.
Okay, I get it. You don't like me much.
No such thing.
It's just, there's just nothing anywhere subscribing to that claim.
No? Her family perhaps?
She had none. In fact, she wrote about this fact in her memoir. Look, she married an African-American man. It would have been impossible.
Improbable, maybe. Dangerous, definitely. But not impossible.
But why would she... I mean, it was a Negro exhibition.
So your research only goes so far.
End of play.
All right.